Hi, my name is Martha Zameda. I'm an LTE Applications Engineer in the Microwave and Communications Division of Agilent Technologies. Today, I'm here to show you how to make an LTE EVM measurement with industry's best EVM performance. In my setup, I have an Agilent MXG vector signal generator configured with a 5 MHz wide LTE uplink signal at a 700 MHz center frequency, which is the frequency band that's used to deploy LTE in the United States. The RF output of the MXG has gone into the RF input of the PXA, and the PXA is running the built-in LTE measurement application. Now let's make the measurements on the PXA. First thing I do is I go to mode and select the LTE measurement application. And you can clearly see the 5 MHz wide modulated signal on the display. Next, I'll go to the measure key. And as you can see, all of the list of one button standard compliant measurements that are supported by the LTE measurement application, from the basic channel power all the way up to spectrum emission mask, and the modulation analysis measurement, which is what we're going to be using to make an EVM measurement. Just want to quickly point out, we also have a conformance EVM measurement, which is a speed optimized EVM measurement targeted for manufacturing use. So let's go to modulation analysis. And as you can see, the signal is not being demodulated because I need to change the direction to an uplink. So by going to mode setup, I'll change the direction from the default downlink to uplink. And as soon as I do that, you'll see the PXA automatically synchronizes to the signal, and you'll see it being demodulated on the display. Since we're talking about EVM, I'm going to zoom onto the error summary trace, where the EVM measurement as well as the other error metrics are reported. So we're going to focus at the EVM, which is the composite EVM, the first metric that's reported there. To make the measurement view easier, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the EVM metric to dB from the default percent. So I do that by going to Measurement Setup, More, Advanced, and Result Format, change that to dB, turn it on. And now the EVM measurement is reported in dB, and we're measuring about minus 50 dB of EVM. The next step is to optimize the input range so we can optimize the residual EVM floor of the PXA. So I do that by going to the amplitude key, and you see a soft key labeled range. When the range is too low, it will overload the PXA's ADC. When the range is too high, it will introduce noise, which will degrade the EVM. So a good rule of thumb is to lower the range until you see an overload message, and you increase it by one step. So let's do that. I'm going to manually lower the range, and you will see as I lower the range, the EVM performance gets better. Right now we're measuring about minus 54, minus 55. So I'm going to continue to reduce the range until I get an overload message. And at about minus 4 dB, I get the input overload message. So I'm going to change that up by 2 dB. So at minus 2 dB, that's the optimum ADC range. And you can see we're measuring about minus 59 dB of composite EVM, which is the lowest EVM floor of any signal analyzer in the market today. So minus 59 dB of EVM floor is clearly a very clean signal. In a real-world environment, you're going to have signals with impairments, and you would like to see deeper in the signal to be able to troubleshoot. One of the advantages of the Agilent LTE measurement application is, in addition to giving you numeric results of EVM, it provides you more than 35 different traces to help you troubleshoot your signal. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of those examples. So I'm going to zoom out of the error summary trace and go back to the default trace, which is showing you four different traces, including the constellation diagram. Here we're looking at EVM across different symbols, spectrum, and then the error summary. So as an example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and change trace number 2 And I'm going to display what we call a frame summary trace. So what the frame summary trace does is it provides you the EVM of the individual channels and signals that are present. And the other advantage is the displays are color-coded based on the signal. So if the overall EVM is high, you'll be, by looking at the channel and the channel color, you'll be able to see which channel or signal is contributing to the high EVM. Of course, if you'd prefer to use markers, instead of just visually looking at the channel and signal, we provide 12 different markers that you can use to help you identify which channels or signals are actually providing with the highest EVM. Today, I've demonstrated how you can optimize the Agilent PXA high-performance signal analyzer to achieve industry's best EVM floor of minus 59 dB. For those of you who are working on LTE Advanced today, we have industry's first and only LTE Advanced solution using our 89600 VSA software. If you'd like to see demonstration of the Agilent PXA or our LTE solutions, please contact your local Agilent representative or visit us at agilent.com/find/PXA. Thank you for watching.